Hello, I'm Justin Smith, and I'd like to share a few helpful hints for using Automated PMI. I want to create some logic for Automated PMI that I can add to the part we have here. Before we get started, I need to make sure I'm using the correct settings. Under the Customer Defaults, I select PMI and select the Advisor tab. Here, I can select different checking modes and active standards. Selecting Advise will allow the advisor to notify you of anything that does not meet standards, while Enforce prevents the user from applying changes that conflict with the selected standard. We can also select between ISO or ASME standards to be advised. For this, we will select ISO. NX provides many out-of-the-box logic rules for users. We will map a location for a custom rule that we will create and reuse later. I have already named and mapped this library here, so I will not need to add a path. If you have Team Center integration, you can also map to the logical rules library here. For the changes to take effect, after selecting OK or Apply, you'll need to restart NX. However, I'll just hit Cancel since I've already applied these changes. If I select the Reuse library, I can see the logical library called MBD Logic Rules Demo, which I mapped earlier. The library also contains a rule I was working on earlier. I'd like to make a few edits to this. I want to test out the logical rules, so I'll select this face. We can see the PMI is added in and that the advisor is giving us a warning, so we need to make a few changes. We can't use straightness when describing a face, so let's change this to flatness. We still have an alert from the advisor, so I'll change the material modifier to none. That clears everything up with the advisor. I can change my delimiter to a decimal if needed, which we can see updates in the part as well. I'll keep the comma for my delimiter. I can also change the precision or significant figures and select to keep or remove trailing and leading zeros. Over in the Node Explorer, I can see my search results from earlier. If you use a particular node a lot, you can select to pin it, and it will be listed here. Let's see what happens if I add this node in. I will also want to merge these two lists as well. The input for tolerance is red, which indicates that this input needs to be satisfied, so I can right-click and create an input. Then I will connect both of these lists to the merge. I don't want to have redundant logic, so if I select this relationship and hit the delete key, I get this message telling me that the downstream connections could be lost. We don't want that, so I select no and go ahead and connect the merge list to this input. Notice that the current connection is marked in blue. This means that the redundant connection will be automatically deleted. We can see that this created more errors, so I'll delete what we added. Once that is cleared out, I just need to reconnect everything, and the PMI looks how we need it to. I want to save this now. If I were to select Save As, this PMI would be saved into the part. But since I just want to save the logic, I'll select Save to save it into the library. Now if we go into the Reuse library and select the Flatness Logic Rule, I can select a face and the PMI will be added to the part. In this demonstration, we set up the advisor, mapped to an appropriate logical rules library, and made some changes to the existing logical rules set. We then added the automated PMI to a part. Thank you.